This is the TrapBurner Stage 2 Thermal Regenerator. The TrapBurner comes with a short metal stand. This is unnecessary if the kiln is placed on a concrete floor. The extra fire bricks wrapped in newspaper should be used to protect the base of the kiln when placing a DPF inside. If a rack was included in your purchase, the extra bricks can be used to protect the base when standing the long cone DPFs on end. The TrapBurner is only necessary when a DPF tests higher than green tag range on the trap tester. The TrapBurner will oxidize 100% of the black soot and cause the appearance to look like new. The high heat process also loosens any hardened ash left in the filter, causing micro cracks that weaken the ash. The TrapBurner is programmed to safely and gradually ramp the heat to 1112 Fahrenheit or 600 Celsius. The program takes a little over 9 hours and usually takes a few hours to cool. After the filter has cooled to ambient temperature, a second pneumatic cleaning is required to blow out any loosened ash. It is unsafe to process any oil, fuel, or coolant-soaked DPFs in the TrapBurner. It is very important to read all precautions and warning labels in the manual and on the machine. Place the DPF in the TrapBurner, close the lid, and secure the lid latch lock. If you purchase the extension rings and rack, you will be able to fit either 2 or 3 DPFs at a time. Press the P1 button and then press start. The digital display will ask if the DPF is oil soaked. Answer 1 for yes and 2 for no. The program will not work if you answer yes. If you answer no to proceed, the display will show a 3-digit code. Input this code on the control pad and press enter. Then press start and the program will begin. The temperature will display alternately with the elapsed program time. After the program is complete, it should be allowed to cool. You may crack the lid 1 inch using the lid lifter to decrease the cooling time. Once the temperature cools to 500 Fahrenheit or 260 Celsius, the lid can be fully opened while the DPF continues cooling. The DPF will remain extremely hot and require proper safety equipment if early removal is necessary. The filter should be allowed to cool to ambient temperature before placing it back in the trap blaster for final pneumatic cleaning. Do not place hot filters over 125 Fahrenheit or 52 Celsius in the trap blaster or on the trap tester. Hot filters can be damaged if cooled too quickly and will also be a fire hazard to the soot sucker if placed in the trap blaster. Make sure to refer to all warnings in the operating manual.